Hey, welcome back to the SysAdmin channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add another domain controller to your domain. They always say friends don't let friends drink and drive. Well, friends also don't let friends have only one domain controller. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to add another domain controller so you have that redundancy. So prior to recording this video, I've already renamed the computer to pack-dc02. I've already set the IP statically to 172.16.10.101, and I've already joined the machine to the domain, so we got all that covered. So now with that out of the way, we're going to go ahead and go into the server manager. We're going to click on add roles and features. All right, so we're going to click next, role-based features installation. We're going to select this DC from the pool, and then we're going to want to install Active Directory domain services. So we'll go ahead and click check that, go ahead and add the features, and then we'll click next. We won't be installing any features here, so we'll click next to that. Next one more time, and finally we'll install. All right, so now that finished installing, we'll go ahead and close this window. And then we'll click on the little triangle on top and promote this server to a domain controller. Since we're adding this domain controller to an existing domain, we're gonna select add domain controller to existing domain. The domain is already preset in there, so we'll click next. And then here we're going to enter in our DSRM password. This should be the same password that you use when you initially set up the environment. I'm going to go ahead and put in mine. We'll click next to the DNS delegation options. And here, since we only have only one other DC in our environment, we're going to select any domain controller. If we click on the drop down, you see that there's only one other available, so any domain controller is fine. Next. And here we'll leave the default installation, default path. That's fine. We'll go ahead and look it over our options. That all looks fine. If you wanted to export this script, we can do that. Let's go ahead and click on that view script and then copy this PowerShell command. If you were doing multiple DCs all at once, then you'd want to use a script just to scale it and automate it. But for now, we're going to go ahead and click next for now. We're not going to be using that. All right, we're going through our prereqs. Everything looks good. We'll go ahead and click the install. And it looks like we're about to reboot right now. So just go ahead and close that. All right, so now I've rebooted and you can see that we're back in the server manager. From here, we'll go ahead and open up the Active Directory users and computers. And as you can see right here, when I click on change domain controller, we'll now see two domain controllers in our environment. So it looks like everything's successful. And that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked it, go ahead and smash that like button. It helps me out a lot. If you have any other ideas on what videos to make, just let me know and I will try to get on that. For now, that's it. Thanks, guys.